welcome to Sports 101, the only show that tests your true knowledge of sports. Dr. Strudler is off skiing with his kids today, so I'll be your substitute, Casey Bryant. Let's introduce today's contestants. To my right here, stage right, we have in the beautiful Winter Classic Boston Bruins jersey, Nick Cavanna. And then to his right, we have Mitchell Zanders making up Stream Team Dream Team. Guys, welcome to the show. Kind of adversarial in the jersey choice there, huh? Yeah, is that going to throw off the chemistry?
No, no, we're going to
beat the Islanders today. It's a team effort.
We're one team. Stream Team, Dream Team. All right. Been that way for 3 years.
Is Hull Canadian? Yeah, so you got like the Team Canada kind of vibe going, I think. Maybe. I don't know. Who knows? Hull could be anywhere. I don't know. He's probably Swiss for all I care. All right. Anyway, so to my left here, we have two of the finest defensemen that Marist Hockey has to offer. Not the finest, but like two of the finest here.
Starting off hockey.
In the White Islanders jersey, we have Nick Rudy Rudziewicz, and to his left, we have Vinny Masters. I'm honestly very shocked that you went with the black Brooklyn jersey.
I actually enjoy the black jersey.
Do you really?
Yeah, he doesn't like them that much, right?
I hate what they represent. If they were anybody else's team, I would like it.
So then, what are you going to think of the color scheme when they move to Hartford?
No, don't even start. Come on.
Oh, come on.
Come on. You're burning bridges.
Yeah, you're really taking shots at
here
us.
Here we go, Casey.
I'm just trying to prove that there's no favorites here. We know. That I'm fully attached and non-biased. You're welcome. Yeah. You're welcome, guys. Anyway, here's how the game works. There are six major categories for our contestants to choose from. The four major sports, MLB, NFL, NBA, and NHL, pop culture, and stadiums, and then there's a final Jeopardy question at the end. Each team will switch off answering six questions to start in the first round, each worth 1 point. In the second round, they will be worth 2 points, and the other team can steal if they get it wrong, but we'll get to that later. I'm going to start here with my right for the first question here. Nick Cavanna is going to answer our first question, get the ball rolling. You have six categories to choose here. Nick, what are you going to go with?
One question. How long do I have to answer?
As long as I deem appropriate.
Oh, good.
Please don't take forever. We've had that before on this show, and it's dead air, so.
I figured that. What's the categories?
MLB, NBA, NFL, NHL, stadiums, and pop culture. This is not the hard
part.
I'll
go with NHL.
You'll go with the NHL.
A lot of pressure right now.
All right, everyone's got the NHL jersey on, so I'm expecting big things here. I made them a little tricky.
May let you down.
All right, well, name the only American city where hockey has failed not once, but twice. Team has moved away twice from this city. And I will remind everyone that each team has one lifeline with their partner, if they happen to know the answer.
I feel like I'm definitely going to get this wrong. I have two guesses.
Okay.
But I only get one.
That's true. It's a 50-50 shot here.
I do know it if you want to use the lifeline.
It's kind of early to go to the whip, though. I don't know. Need an answer.
All right. I'm going to go with Carolina.
That is incorrect. Atlanta
is the city. That was my second one.
Atlanta is the city that failed twice. The Atlanta Flames moved to Calgary, and then the Atlanta Thrashers moved to Winnipeg. But that's all right. There's still plenty of game to go along. Nick Rudziewicz is going to take a stab at things here. What do you got, Nick?
Pop culture, please.
You're going to go with the pop culture question. All right. Nick, life is just this game of inches. Al Pacino gives one of the most iconic locker room speeches in movie history with this 99 sports movie.
Any given Sunday, I was watching it about an hour.
You guys get the questions early. You were on that Google Doc?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, well, hey, an early lead here for Team Kokomo here to my left here. Big Beach Boys fans, I guess, right?
Huge Beach Boys fans.
Something like that.
Absolutely. This is a PG show here, guys. Anyway, we're going to move on over to Mitchell here to get his first question of the day. Mitchell, what do you got?
I'll take NFL.
You're going to take the NFL. All right. Who is the only QB in this group that has not thrown for 5,000 yards in a season? Is it Tom Brady, Matt Stafford, Aaron Rodgers, or Drew Brees?
Aaron Rodgers.
That is correct. Good job there, Mitchell. All right, getting back on the board, getting them back in the game. That's important. All right, so, Vinny, what do you got?
I'll go with MLB.
Going with MLB. All right. He hit his 600th career home run as a Texas Ranger. He retired as a Baltimore Oriole. But if he ever reaches the Hall, it will be as a Chicago Cub. Who am I thinking of? It's a tricky question.
Could you repeat it just
so
I get the team straight?
Sure, absolutely. 600th career home run as a Texas Ranger. He retired as a Baltimore Oriole. But if he ever reaches the Hall, It will be as a Chicago Cub.
I think I might have saw an article on him today, but I'm not sure. Is it Sammy Sosa?
It is Sammy Sosa. All right, hey, that's good. And
humming.
Yeah.
Corked bats and all.
Yeah, Sammy Sosa. Yeah, more than that, though.
Yeah, exactly. There's going to have to be a lot of fun havery for him to get involved.
How many asterisks are you allowed in one Hall of Fame ballot?
He's got at least three.
At least three.
Definitely hurt his chances.
All right, Nick, we're going to move on over to you.
I'll go with stadiums.
Going to go with stadiums. We're going to dip into the stadiums here. All right.
I'm trying to let you down, Mitchell.
Okay. Chemistry's off already. I told you it would be a factor. Nick, Bernie slides the slide at this MLB ballpark.
Do you have this one?
Yep.
Might have to use my lifeline on this one.
All right, if you want to use it.
I definitely heard that, but like.
Bernie slides the slide at this park. Are you using your lifeline?
What do you think?
I mean, we're down one, and we have a question in hand, so yeah.
Yeah, we're using it.
What are you, the Maple Leafs? You're trying to calculate how many games in hand you have?
Maple Leafs will not make the playoffs.
Bold. Hey, did you hear the Austin Matthews rap song that Barstool promoted today? That could provide the proper momentum. Anyway, are you using your lifeline?
Yes.
All right. So.
It's Miller Park.
Miller Park, that is correct. The Milwaukee Brewers Stadium.
I watched Mr. 3000 2 days ago. I think something's going up here.
We gotta be careful.
Film. Oh my God, Mr. 3000.
It's on Netflix. Like, any given Sundays on HBO Go.
That's what I thought at first. But
yeah. These guys came prepared.
Yeah, we did.
At least you came prepared in one aspect here. So, Nick, what do you got?
Yeah, I'm going to go with MLB.
Going with the MLB. That does it for the MLB here for the remainder of the game. Nick. This current AL outfielder is the only MLB player to win the MVP award after being the runner-up the previous 2 years.
Is it Mike Trout?
It is Mike Trout. That is correct. All right. So the Maki team putting the pressure on here. Mitchell, we're going to move on over to you. What do you got?
Am I allowed to take the same category or no?
Absolutely.
Okay, then I'm taking NFL again.
You're going to take the NFL. That does it for the NFL for the remainder of the game. You can clear them out early.
That's fine by me.
All right, Mitchell. Mm-hmm. Tommy Maddox is one of four players to ever win both an XFL championship and a Super Bowl. What team did he win the Super Bowl with as a backup in 2005?
The Pittsburgh Steelers.
That is correct. Someone saw the This is the XFL 30 for 30 that came out earlier this month, huh?
Yep.
Oh, that was wonderful.
Great. Beautiful.
It's beautiful. Beautiful documentary. It brings tears to your eyes. Yeah. How did that not work? So many good ideas. The human coin toss, the no fair catch. How did it not work?
I don't know.
Anyway, Vinny, we're going to move on over to you here. What do you got?
I'm going to go to the bread and butter here, NHL.
We're going to go with the NHL. All right, I'm expecting big things out of this team.
I hope.
If you get it wrong, I'm going to talk to Coach Beck. We're going to get more minutes for Daniel Roberts on the power play. So, Vinny, this former NHL goaltender designed his mask to look like his nickname, the famed Stephen King dog, Cujo.
Curtis Joseph.
Curtis Joseph is correct.
I thought he was going to say the Boston Bruins guy with the stitches.
We were talking about that today, too.
This was part of our practice on Sporkle. We were going through Vezina winners, and we couldn't remember.
I can't believe that you actually went through a practice round.
Got to come prepared, right?
I really didn't think that there was that much preparation
Four for four. You can't question the process.
Trust the process. Trust the process.
Clearly, I didn't come prepared.
Oh, lordy lord. All right, so we're going to move on back over to you here, Nick.
What categories we got left?
So you still have MLB, both your questions, the NBA, NHL stadiums, and pop culture. You are tapped out for football for the remainder of the game.
All right, I'll go back to stadiums.
You're going to go back to stadiums? That does it for stadiums for this game.
This could be ugly, but...
All right. They may be at the Joe now, but this NHL team will be at the Little Caesars Arena next season.
Detroit Red Wings.
Very good.
I come on the board.
Yeah,
RIP Mike Lilich, man. The Little Caesars Arena. I mean, that may be the worst stadium name of all time. Maybe Jobbings.com has it for Phoenix.
I mean, there's the Smoothie King Center.
Yeah, I was just going to say where they had the All-Star game.
Everybody thinks the University of Phoenix plays at the University of Phoenix Stadium. So.
That's true. Yeah, I didn't think of it. So, got to love corporate America, right? Go capitalism.
I mean, yeah.
We're going to go back on over to you here, Nick. What do you got?
I'm going to go pop culture again.
Pop culture. That taps you out for pop culture. It went from book to film to television in any form. It's high school football drama.
Friday Night Lights.
Friday Night Lights is correct.
Humming.
Staying on top by one. Team Kokomo rolling here. QB1. The pressure is on.
QB1.
Gonna go over to you, Mitchell.
All right, I'll take NBA.
NBA, first tap here into the NBA. Patrick Ewing is one of the best to never win a ring. The closest he came was in 1994 when he was blocked by the all-time block king and the Houston Rockets.
Hakeem Olajuwon.
Hakeem Olajuwon is correct. We got ourselves a gamer, Mitchell, keeping him in. We're going to go over to you here, Vinny, to close out round one to stay on top by one. What do you got?
All right, I'll take NBA also.
You got to take the NBA. All right. Vinny, who is the only NBA player to win three dunk titles? And this is multiple choice. Is it Nate Robinson, Zach LaVine, Vince Carter, or Julius Irving?
Could you say the first one?
Sure, yeah. The only NBA player to win three dunk titles. Robinson, Nate Robinson, Zach LaVine, Vince Carter, or Julius Irving?
I know Julius Irving has an ABA one. Anyone might have won one in the NBA. It's Nate Robinson.
It is Nate Robinson. Yeah. Very good. Pulling it out at the end there. I always remember his dunk over Dwight Howard.
That was
unreal.
That was the best. I love Nate Robinson.
When he wore all the all green Knicks jersey.
Oh, yeah.
So sick.
I love Nate Robinson. That'll do it for round one here. Very solid game here so far. It is currently 6-5 in favor of Team Kokomo, but we are coming up to the danger round in round two. Stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Sports 101, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Casey Bryant. So far, Team Kokomo has a 6-5 advantage over Team Stream Team Dream Team, which in my head I had to work a lot harder than I thought I would to get that out without stuttering over it, so I'm very proud of myself for that. Anyway, we are moving into our danger round here. Every correct question is worth 2 points, but if they get it wrong, the other team has the chance to steal it for 1 point. Team Kokomo still has their lifeline. Team Stream Team Dream Team has used it already on the Miller Park question as Mitchell shoots a dirty look to his partner. But the redemption starts now here. To give yourself the lead if you get a question right, Nick, what are you going to go with?
Oh, I get to go first.
You do. God. It stays with you.
I'll go with MLB, I guess.
MLB. All right.
Don't look at me, Mitchell.
In 1971, this team set the record. Don't shake your head yet. All right. In 1971, this team set the record for most 20-game winners on one team with Dave McNally, Mike Queller, Pat Dobson, and Jim Palmer.
Well, the only name I knew there was Jim Palmer, so that's good.
I mean, that gives you a hint enough.
I feel like I should know this.
You should.
I should.
I'm going to tell you right now, you should. Thinks you already used your lifeline.
I'm going to go with the St. Louis Cardinals.
That is incorrect. Yeah, do we have an answer from Team Kokomo?
So if we steal it and get it wrong, do we lose a point still?
No.
So we can just guess.
That's true. You can just guess.
And can we confer on it, or we still only have one?
You can confer, yes. It works like Family Feud. You can work together here to steal the point.
So Jim, what was the year?
1971. Jim Palmer, Dave McNally, Mike Queller, and Pat Dobson. Fun fact, I have Dave McNally's autograph.
What team did he play for?
71, 72.
Gonna need an answer.
Just throw a team in there.
Throw a team.
Baltimore Orioles.
That is correct.
No!
That is a point for Team Kokomo. Desperation shot at the buzzer. It goes in.
Jim Palmer sounded familiar for some reason. I associated the name with a color and I said it. I don't know why.
The basic workings of MS's
my brain.
All that hockey is really.
That's why it's so easy to get into my head.
Oh, man. All those hits to the head are simplifying your brain.
He's the one with the concussion.
That's true. All right. Well, Nick, you can really stick the dagger in Team Stream Team Dream Team. What do you got here?
I'll take stadiums, please.
You're going to take stadiums. All right. This is your first dip here into stadiums. This stadium is home to the only foul pole under 300 feet away from home plate in the MLB.
That's easy.
Vinny calling you out saying it's easy. All right.
It's second round. They definitely know this. If I'm going to use
They definitely know this.
You're going to use your lifeline?
My conferral.
All right. You can say it aloud. It's fine.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. I just wasn't 100% right? sure. Fenway Park?
It is Fenway Park. Very sorry, good. The pesky pole. Yeah. Yeah. I figured.
That's why we couldn't let it go to them. They would have definitely gotten that right.
That is true. The Boston fan over here.
Strategy.
All right, so we're going to throw it back over to you here, Mitchell.
I'll just finish NBA.
All right, he's going to go with the NBA. He went in the locker room and said, which one of you guys is coming in second? And he was right, because this Celtics legend won the three-point contest 3 years in a row.
All right.
Legendary Celtic, and I'll bet the Boston fan next to you is stewing.
I'm going to take verbal cues with the question and go with Larry Legend, Larry Bird.
That is correct. Very good. He knows how to read between the lines. That's good. I put little hints in there. I'm trying not to make things impossible.
I didn't know that one.
we appreciate fairness here at Sports 101. All right, that's good. So we're going to throw it over to you here, Vinny. What do you got?
What categories do we have left?
You still have NBA, NFL, one NHL question, your bread and butter, as you like to call it, and you still have a stadium question.
I'll go NBA again.
You're going to go with the NBA. All right, so he's already out of NBA questions. Here we go. Russell Westbrook is on pace to match this guy, the only player to average a triple-double in a season.
Oscar Robertson, sorry.
Taking the cue to speak into the mic, all right? That's good. We're a professional organization here at MCTV, all right? We may not have working teleprompters, but we have working microphones, and that we can hang our hats on.
I knew
on.
It so quickly, I just had to say it before I forgot.
I don't even have a joke at the ready. All right, so we're going to throw it back over to you, right. Nick.
We're struggling. How many categories we got left?
You still have MLB, you still have NHL, and you still have both your pop culture questions.
What do you think, MLB or NHL for me?
You take the NHL. Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll take the NHL.
You'll take the NHL. All right. Jean Rattel, Rod Gilbert, and Vic Hatfield made up a fearsome line for the New York Rangers in the 1970s, dubbed, was it the rag line, the gag line, the gas line, or the French Connection? What was the nickname of Jean Rattel, Rod Gilbert, and Vic Hatfield?
Can you repeat the answers?
Yes. Was it the rag line, the gag line, the gas line, or the French Connection for the Rangers in the 70s?
I believe it was the rag line.
That would be incorrect. We have a chance here for a stolen point over here for Team Kokomo.
The French Connection?
That is incorrect.
Oh, is it really?
The French Connection was from Buffalo in the 70s. We were looking for the gag line. The goal really of game line sense. Of Vic Hatfield, Jean Rattel, and Rod Gilbert. Jean Rattel, incidentally, getting his number retired at Madison Square Garden next season.
Number 19, baby.
A little rattled.
Yes, but Foss is going to have to find a new number. Oh, wow.
I thought that was...
So, a blessing in disguise here for Team Stream Team Dream Team.
Yeah, sorry. I thought I knew it right when you said Rod Gilbert. I thought it was the French Connection.
And that's the tricky part.
It was a team loss. I didn't know it as well.
Yeah.
I have to take one.
Right, that's a team guy right there.
What a team guy. He's always giving the fist bumps as people go out.
We are losing two alternate captains next year. Coach Beck, if you're watching.
If you're watching,
my vote's in.
Well, that's all that matters. So we're going to throw it on over to you guys.
I'm going to go with stadiums. I'll close it out.
You're going to close out the stadiums. All right, Nick, you can rock the red at the Verizon Center, nicknamed the phone booth, located in this East Coast city.
Washington, D.C.
That is correct. The Verizon Center in Washington, D.C., home of the Washington Capitals, where you can rock the red. I hate the Capitals. I think, given all the sports teams here that are represented, I'm assuming I'm not alone in my hatred of the Capitals. Yes?
Hate the Capitals.
I do have an Alexander Ovechkin jersey hanging in my room.
I don't hate the Capitals. And to keep the topic on stadiums, the red stanchions are sick. We need. All right,
that's minus 500 from Team Kokomo. Can we mark that down?
I think we won. We just won.
Jeff Jones, mark that down.
We need red stanchions at the Civic Center. That's a fact.
Dig into that Marist Hockey Fund, baby.
The non-existent Marist Hockey Fund.
All $2.
A bucket of pucks.
Exactly, when the ice is still there.
Yeah.
And double XL shirts.
All right, so we're going to throw it on over to you, Mitchell.
Are you going to want an MLB question later, or?
Yeah, you do whatever you want to do.
All right.
You're carrying me.
I'll take MLB.
Closing out the MLB, leaving both your pop culture questions here for the last round.
Mm-hmm.
Mitchell, this former Brewer slugger once starred in a McDonald's commercial as a kid in 1992. He did it alongside his ball-playing father.
Can you repeat the question, please?
Yes. This former Brewer's slugger once starred in a McDonald's commercial as a kid in 92. and he did it alongside his ball-playing father.
Okay, yeah, it's Prince Fielder.
It is Prince Fielder. You know, Prince Fielder has his own cooking show coming up.
Yeah, so I heard about that. Good for him.
Good for you
Fielder's
know he's got
choice.
Fielder's choice.
That's the name of it.
That is fantastic.
Fielder's choice is the name of it.
That is the best. That is the best option for a show ever. Vinny, something to do after retirement. There you go.
Wait, what?
No.
Who said that?
All right, so Vinny, you're up here. What do you want?
Could you let us know the score, please?
Absolutely. Steph Jones, do we have a score check over there?
Total or just this round?
Total.
Total.
We have 13 Kokomo and
math. 13-9 right. so
okay.
far.
And what are the categories we have left?
You still have both NFL questions, your bread and butter, and that is all, actually. You have three
we'll
questions.
The NFL. Take
Tom Brady's coming.
Well, how does the last round work? It's double, right? So, like,
in Final Jeopardy, you double the score. But, like, you still have to answer all three of these questions. So, either way, you're getting an NFL question, basically.
I know. Like, so, should we use the NHL now? Or?
They sound like the Falcons over there. They're getting nervous.
Because we can know. Because we can
yeah, we'll
do the NFL.
It was
we'll take NFL. We'll take NFL.
You'll take NFL. All right. Vinny, not many people know the hit song New England, The Patriots, and We. Maybe that's because another team that year was doing the Super Bowl shuffle all the way to the 85 title. Who did the Super Bowl shuffle? Beat the Patriots in the 85 Super Bowl.
Super Bowl shuffle. I've seen the commercial, I'm pretty sure. I don't
I'll bet you have.
85. And I don't have my
you don't have your lifeline.
I got it.
But he's dancing over here because he knows the answer.
I'm doing the Super Bowl shuffle. Let's all do it.
Oh, yeah. Chicago Bears.
That is correct. He pulls it out, the Chicago Bears. Important question here. So we're going to go on over to you here, Nick.
You're killing me.
You
got
it.
So you only have your pop culture questions at the ready.
I think I'll take pop culture.
Are you sure? We could bring in the bonus soccer round that I've been hiding in my back pocket.
Throw it in there. Why not?
You've got your water polo round that I know you've been waiting for.
Answer is drowning people.
Here we go. Nathan West got his Hollywood start as the Iceland goalie in The Mighty Ducks 2, but he later went on to play Rob McClanahan in this hockey movie.
A miracle.
That is miracle. That is correct. My mind was blown.
That is my favorite
movie.
On
IMDb.
I had no idea.
Yeah, he was Segi Wiesel in The Mighty Ducks 2.
Miracle.
Yeah,
shout out to Dave Hughes.
The one that
Dave
got drilled in the face by
he gets drilled in the face and then he has the bruise on
his
palm.
Yeah.
Ah,
rough showing.
What a movie.
Adam Banks makes him look silly.
Absolutely. When he has to twist his wrist and he can't do... Oh,
kind of looks like me on Breakaway, am I right?
I'd say he looks more like Connor Swim on Breakaway.
A lot of love to PP1 tonight. Yeah. A ton of love to PP1. Unreal.
All right, so Nick, you have either the NFL or the NHL at the ready here for your final.
NFL, please.
You're going to go with the NFL. The New England Patriots have won every single AFC East title since 2003 but one. Who won the 2008 AFC East title?
Come on.
that was tough. Oh, it's the Jets.
It is not the Jets.
2008?
We have a question over here.
They were 1-15 the year before, and then they had a 10-game turnaround, the Miami Dolphins.
Miami Dolphins. Mitchell with the show off, so that's a point for Team Stream, Team Dream Team, getting back into it, chipping away at that deficit.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so the final question over to you here, Mitchell.
Yeah, I'll take it.
All right.
Okay.
This season... The Islanders gave away a bobblehead of the star of this movie, complete with a bobble leg, presumably, so you can sweep it. What movie?
I know.
Bobblehead complete with a bobble leg, presumably, so you can sweep it. Any thoughts?
You know for sure.
Mm-hmm.
It's sounding like confidence over here from Team Kokomo, so the
confidence.
Pressure's on.
See the jerseys, though. He was probably at the game.
Nah.
Any hints?
I'm just going to throw Goon out there.
That is incorrect. So a chance for Kokomo.
Ralph Macchio in The Karate Kid?
That is correct. Sweep the leg, Johnny. You got to get him a body bag. That's a classic movie here. And I guess the Islanders fans have the advantage in that one. I tried to divvy it up. I tried to help you out. But Vinny, the final question is over to you here for this round. So... He entered this season as the longest tenured head coach in the NHL, but he now has a new home in Eastern Canada. You can't prove it yet.
It's recent.
Yes.
Yeah. Extremely recent.
It is extremely recent.
I'm going to have to go with Claude Julien.
That is correct, and he pulls it out at the very end, so that will do it here for...
Absolute dagger. Fun fact,
the second time that Bruce Claude Julien has replaced Michel Therrien in Montreal.
Yes.
Did that in 2003. He replaced him. So we're going to move right ahead here to our final Jeopardy round. Now, I will say that this question does have a theme to it. The theme here is nicknames. There are multiple answers to this question. I'm going to give you four nicknames from one of each of the major sports. You're going to have to identify the player that goes along with this nickname. Whoever answers the most correctly doubles their score. In the event of a tie, you both double your score, which would mean that the current leader wins. So the pressure's on here. We're going to start over here with the current trailing team. If we have a scoring update from Stephanie Jones over there, our lovely scorekeeper, do we have a score count?
We got Kokomo at 18. Dream team, that is hard, at 12.
18-12 here, so you're going to have to get a lot of these right here, but I'm going to throw four nicknames at you. Yes, you are working together on this one.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm going to throw four nicknames at you. I'm not going to specify the sport, but you're going to have to identify the player that goes along with it. So your four nicknames are The Sheriff, Super Mario, The Answer, and The Freak.
Oh, I know all three.
Well, you can't steal. So we have The Sheriff, Super Mario, The Answer, and The Freak for Final Jeopardy. I believe this would be the biggest deficit that a team has come back from. I could be wrong, though. You can think aloud as well. So this isn't dead air.
I know the sheriff. I know the answer. And I know. I don't know the freak, to be honest.
We're trying to.
I know the Greek freak.
It's not the Greek freak.
And what was the second one?
We have the Sheriff, Super Mario, the Answer, and the Freak. Do you want to go one at a time, perhaps?
We're still trying to figure out this fourth one, so...
Give me the three that you have, then.
Baseball? All right. So, for the NFL, the Sheriff, Peyton Manning.
That is correct.
For the NHL, Super Mario, Mario Lemieux.
That is correct.
For the NBA, the Answer, Allen Iverson.
That is correct. 3-3.
And so, we're working on the Freak.
Gonna need an answer.
MLB.
You have narrowed down that as a baseball player. That is good. Mm-hmm. That's tricky. That eliminates Javon Kearse because I looked it up, and apparently Javon Kearse is also nicknamed the Freak. Mm-hmm. Did not know that.
Yeah. Long time Titan and Eagle.
This kid's just pulling out everyone's former team here. Cold-blooded assassin
you have any
over
thoughts
here.
On the Freak?
I was thinking of the Greek Freak, but that was
Any thoughts? Throw a name out.
A-Rod.
No. It is not.
You use his nickname to say another nickname.
Yeah, more than one nickname.
Yeah. I suppose that's true. Ted Williams was Teddy Ballgame and the Splendid Splinter, so people can have two nicknames, but we were looking for Tim Lincecum. Nice. Big time Timmy Jims.
That's right.
The Freak. He was currently trying to make yet another comeback here. He tried out with the Angels and it didn't work out so well.
Shorter.
It is short hair. He ditched his stoner hair.
Yeah.
He did not ditch the stoning, but he ditched the hair. So we're going to move on over here. You need three or four to seal the victory here. If you get only two, they win.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Whoever gets the most doubles their score.
Okay, all right.
So they would end up with 24. You would end up with only 18. So for you guys, we have The Truth, The Big Unit, The Finnish Flash, and CJ2K.
I know all of them.
You know all of them. Oh, man. Right.
Can you say the first one again?
The Truth.
The Truth is Paul Pierce.
Correct. One.
Can you say the second one?
The Big Unit.
The Big Unit's Randy Johnson.
2-2.
And three was the Finnish Flash. Tame Asani.
Correct. 3-3.
And what was the fourth one?
CJ2K.
Chris Johnson.
Chris Johnson, and that is correct. And we have ourselves a winner, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to Team Kokomo. Marist Hockey bringing home the Sports 101 trophy. They're bringing home the Route 87 Challenge Cup and the Sports 101 trophy.
Two
here.
Titles?
Not the SEC.
Not regionals. Not SEC, but they come away with something here.
We'll take what we can get.
Exactly. So you guys do win a prize here. Since it is February, made you guys a clever little Valentine here. It's a heart that says you did the thing. So congratulations, guys. You can hang this up in the hockey house. Next to all your Alex Ovechkin inexplicable jerseys here.
That's at my actual house.
Are you saying this isn't going up in your actual house?
No, this is gonna.
My
go
mom might put that on the
here.
Fridge.
I made this special for you guys.
do they play this back?
Forget it. I'll give it to Lucas Milbank, who will appreciate it.
Do they play this?
We'll take
play
it. We'll gladly take it.
Mitchell says he'll take the heart.
This is not live on TV, though.
Nobody
this
loves
gets
us.
Gets posted to YouTube afterward. To our
oh, so my mom can watch.
Yes, she can.
Okay.
We won.
Cool. We won.
Hi, Mrs. Masters.
Hi, Mrs. Rodswick.
All right, keep the mom
Sanders,
over there.
I'm sorry,
right,
I let guys. Your son down.
That'll do it here for Sports 101. I want to thank special very much here. Team Stream Team, Dream Team, Nick Cavanna, and Mitchell Zanders. Guys, thank you so much. You guys are great sports over there.
Thank you.
So really appreciate it. Congratulations to Nick Rodswick and Vinny Masters. That'll do it here for Sports 101. I'm your host, Casey Bryant. Have a good night.